I know that virtue to be in you, Brutus, as well as I do know your outward favour. Well, honour is the subject of my story. I cannot tell what you and other men think of this life, but for my single self, I had as lief not be as live to be in awe of such a thing as I myself. I was born as free as Caesar. So were you. We both have fed as well, and we can both endure the winter's cold as well as he. For once upon a raw and gusty day, the troubled Tiber, chafing with her shores, said Caesar to me, "Darest thou, Cassius, now leap in with me into this angry flood and swim to yonder point?" Upon the word, accounted as I was, I plunged in and bade him follow. So indeed he did. The torrent roared, and we did buffet it with lusty sinews, throwing it aside and stemming it with hearts of controversy. But ere we could arrive the point proposed, Caesar cried, "Help me, Cassius, or I sink." Aye, as Aeneas, our great ancestor, did from the flames of Troy upon his shoulder the old Anchises bear, so I, from the waves of Tiber, did the tyrant Caesar. And this man has now become a god, and Cassius is a wretched creature, and must bend his body if Caesar carelessly but nod on him. He had a fever when he was in Spain, and when the fit was on him, I did mark how he did shake. 'Tis true, this god did shake. His coward lips did from their colour fly, and that same eye, whose bend doth awe the world, did lose its lustre. I did hear him groan. I, in that tongue of his, that bade the Romans mark him and write his speeches in their books, alas, it cried, "Give me some drink, Titinius," as a sick girl.